Hello everyone. In this video I want to talk about sequences in GeoGebra. And the first question that we will cover is how to define sequence in GeoGebra. And it's quite simple. We go to the algebra mode and we choose any name of the sequence. Let's say S is the sequence equality sign, and we will use the curved brackets and we list the terms of the sequence. For example, 1 minus 5, 0, 77, 100, for example. And press enter, then we get a sequence with these elements. And of course, since this is a sequence, the order of the terms is important and the repetition is allowed here. And GeoGebra starts from the first term. This is the first term, second, and so on. For example, if I want to get, let's say, the first term of the sequence, I get 1. The second term is minus 5. So the indexing starts from 1 here. Okay, and let's maybe introduce another sequence. And there are some other ways to introduce sequences. For example, if you want to use some formula, let's maybe B is, we will use the tool sequence. You see how many options you have here. So the first one, you need to enter just end value. This means that the sequence will contain the positive integers ending with this given value. And the increment is 1, of course. Here, start value and end value, the same sense. We start with something, some integer, and end with some integer with increment 1. Here we can change the increment. Let's say we want to make it 0.5 and so on. And here we can introduce the expression. For example, it can be some function which determines the sequence. For example, let's choose this one. The expression, let's say we want to get n squared, we want to get 5 numbers which are squares of the first 5 integers, for example. Then we need variable, in our case this is n. The start value, let's say we start from 1 and we end until 5. So you see we get a sequence of 5 squares of the first 5 squares. Okay, and in GeoGebra, let me also note that in GeoGebra, the sequence can be not just sequence of numbers, it can be sequence of anything. For example, let me write a sequence of points. So the expression is, let's say n square variable n from, let's say, 0 to 5. You see, we get a sequence of points. This is 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4, 5, 3, 9, and so on. Okay. And also we can be also not points, maybe it can be segments, for example. The sequence of segments. Let's say the first point is maybe n squared, and the second point, let's say n plus 1, in brackets, n plus 1 squared. Okay, and the variable is also n, and again, let's say we start from 0 to 5. You see the sequence of segments from 0, 1, from 1 to this point, from 1, 1 to 2, 4, from 2, 4 to 3, 9, and so on. Okay, so this is about definition of sequences. And we now are going to solve this problem here. The first one, defined two arbitrary sequences, S and B, of the same length, which we already did. So these two sequences are of length 5, because they have 5 terms each. And the second task here to find linear combination of these sequences. And GeoGebra understands well operations on sequences. For example, you can sum them, you can take difference, you can multiply them by numbers, you can even take powers, which means that each term is squared in this case. You can even take functions like sine and cosine. This is fine in GeoGebra. And here we need to find 5s minus 3b. So this is this sequence. GeoGebra called it L3. Okay, and next task, we need to find delta, so the difference, and summations of a given sequence. And there are no commas in GeoGebra, but this is quite simple in fact. If we use the term sequence, let's say we want to find delta of S of the first sequence, what we can do, we can start from sequence and let's choose this one. And by definition, this new sequence is the difference S of n plus 1 term, right? Okay, maybe we will start with n minus S n minus 1. And the length is n, and we start from 1. Now we have to start from 2 here, right? Okay, the first one, S2 minus S1, and so on, until the last one will be S5 minus S4, so until 5. So you see the sequence, the difference of the sequence S. And indeed you can check the first one is minus 5 minus 1, the second one is 0 minus 5, which is 5, this one 77 minus 0, 77, this is 100 minus 77, which is 23. So this is indeed the difference of sequence S. Let me rename it delta S. Okay, and we can do also the summation. So, but summation is a bit more complicated, but again, we will use the term sequence. And we will use also the sum operation. So here we will use sum, and here we will, the sum operation will list S, and we will sum first n terms of S. So the first one will be the sum of just one term. So the first term of this sequence will be just S1, so just one. The second term, the sum of 1 and minus 5. The third term, the sum of these three, and so on. The variable is n, and we start with 1 until the nth value will be 5, right? Because the last one will be the sum of 5 terms, right? So we get this sequence. Let's check. 1 minus 5 is minus 4, plus 0 is minus 4, plus 77 is 73, plus 100 is 100 is 73. So everything is correct. But in summation, in the definition of summation, we get firstly 0, the first term. So we need to add 0 here. And in GeoGebra, we can glue the sequences together. So this is operation append. You see we can append some list with an object and object with a list. List is the sequence here in GeoGebra. So let's choose the second one, and the object that we want to add is 0, and the list that we want to glue with is L4. So you see we get summation. Let me call it summation S. Okay, so this is the sequence, which is summation of the sequence S. Okay, and sometimes it's useful if you, for example, want to change S, you want this delta s and summation of s also automatically be changed. For example, if you change just numbers, it's okay, it will be different, but if you change the length of this s, for example, I want to add one more term, let's say 43, I want this sequence automatically to be changed. Also, in this case, it's good to add here not 5, but there is some operation length of s, of the sequence s. In this case, you see that delta automatically becomes of length 5 when we get s of length 6. And if we add more terms, you see we have automatically this term here. Or if we remove this term, this also removed from delta. And you can do the same, of course, in this sequence. So we need to write here length of s. Okay, and you see automatically in this summation, the lengths changed. Okay, so this is about delta and summation of s. Let's now move on to part 4, when we need to find h6. Let me remind you that h6 is the binomial coefficient with the numbers n6, right? And therefore, we need to construct a sequence with the binomial. Okay, they have this C and R. So this is n, the number n first variable. And the second number is 6. In our case, R is just 6. The variable is n, and we need from 1 to up to 15 terms, let's choose 16. Okay, probably we need from 0, right? Up to 15, then we get the first 6 must be zeros, that's right. Okay, so this is correct. Let's call it H6. So we can easily get the sequence we need. This H15s is, so H6 15s is, now 15s, they mean, if we want to find 15s, then we need 16s, because in our case, we start from 0. In this case, GeoGebra starts the index from 1, right? So therefore, we need H16s. Okay, so that's it for this video. I'm Anna Tomskova. Thanks for listening.